Hey everyone, welcome back. We are doing a little mini series, if you will. My name is Lynn. I'm trying to help you save money, earn money, use your money wisely, and how to spend money. Money's, you know, things are tight. Things are tight. Things are tough. It's lean times. It's, you know, whatever you want to call it. But that's life. You know, it's where we are in life. And there's nothing I can do right now to change the fact that, you know, egg prices are up and down like crazy. Okay, do I go and buy chickens? That's an option. It's not an option for everyone. But then I have to buy chicken feed, and chicken feed's expensive. And then I still have to do the investment of a chicken coop and the investment of chickens. Now, all of that is a great thing. And yes, you can have abundance of fresh eggs. But sometimes that's just not the option, and you're just going to have to deal with the fact that eggs cost a lot of money. So what do? How do we earn money, save money, use our money well, and learn how to spend our money well when things are tough and egg prices are, I'm just using that as an example, there's everything, gas, everything. You can't stop living. That's not the way to go. But the thing is, you can learn how to live better. You can live more frugally, more intentionally. You know, I'm Scottish. One of my nationalities, if you want to say, is Scottish. And my one family on the other side that's Irish would always say, oh, the Scottish people are cheap because they use everything. They are probably one of the most frugal country of people that I know of. And my dad would say Scottish people aren't cheap. They're smart and they're frugal. Hence, we became smart shoppers in the Wilson family. And we have always taught our children, we were never poor. We were always smart shoppers. I never wanted my kids to feel like we were poor, that we lived under the poverty level, that we didn't have what everybody else had because we were poor. We were just smart shoppers, and we chose not to buy those things because, and we would just do it on a positive side versus a negative side. Maybe you find yourself in a situation of feeling that way, that I'm poor, I have no money, I'm broke, it's hopeless, I can't afford anything, I can't do anything. I get it. I totally get it, because I go in a slump like that myself, and I get frustrated and overwhelmed, and I tell my husband, this is ridiculous. But then I have to remember what I've taught my children, and we are smart shoppers. How am I going to do this in a better way, in a more frugal way? How can I make this work? So I'm doing this little mini series, if you will, on saving, using, spending, and earning your money in a better way. So I hope you enjoy this. Give it a thumbs up if it's something you enjoy, want to continue. I'd love to hear your feedback and comments below. If you missed my story on how we spent $90 on a battery and it didn't work because it ended up being upside down, that I had to find that out via another situation, go back and I'll leave it in the description below, but you can certainly go back and watch that video and maybe learn a lesson that I had to learn from that particular life experience, which has taught me a lot. So we talked about a lot of things the other day, and I did leave you on a cliffhanger about my, let me get it, macaroni and cheese saga. All right, let me put my notebook down. So here's the scoop. I was raised on this. I love Kraft macaroni and cheese. So before we get in any further, yes, I make homemade macaroni and cheese. Yes, I know how to make it, and I do make it. I like this better. I enjoy homemade macaroni and cheese when I make a dinner and we're maybe having ham or something, and I make a big tray of homemade macaroni and cheese. But like a snacky dinner, or just because it's, I need comfort food, I will go to this. You can, I'll probably share it on another story time again on another video, but I have shared it. Our story of how we had to eat macaroni and cheese sometimes 5 to 7 nights a week because it was 33 cents a box, and that's all I could afford to feed my kids. but how I did it in a unique way. If you want to hear that story again, leave a comment and I will share that on the next video. So leave me a comment if you want me to share that. How we ate 33 cents a box macaroni and cheese 5 to 7 nights a week, but it never looked the same. It never tasted the same. And my kids never knew we were poor. They thought we just lived a very luxurious lifestyle eating 33 cents macaroni and cheese. So you can decide if you want to hear that story, if you haven't heard it, or if you want to hear it again, by leaving a comment below. So here's the scoop. My son goes through, when he makes this, he'll make 2 boxes at a time, eat some, and then put it in the fridge for a number of days and kind of pick at it, use it as a side dish, whatever. This is what he does. Our son is an adult. He's a young adult, just turned an adult age, and has some special needs along with that. So keeping life simple for him, this was one thing we could teach him to cook. He's mastered it. He likes it. He loves it. I'm okay with it. I don't like the Walmart brand. I don't like ShopRite's brand. If we have to, we will. I like this brand. So I have to go and be a smart shopper where to buy it. It's $1.25 currently at the Dollar Tree. It was $1.37 at currently at Walmart the last time I checked. And it was $1.52 the last time I checked at ShopRite. Now they vary. Dollar Tree's down the street. Yes, I can get it for $1.25. Well, I thought, you know what? I've never checked Amazon. I went and I checked Amazon. Lo and behold, it was 92 cents a box. What can you possibly get under a dollar anymore? So I thought it came in a case of, how many did it come in a case of? 35. I thought, you know what? I'm a big stockpiler. We'll use it up. I'll get 35 boxes that'll last us quite a while. I'll put some in the pantry, stick the rest in the stockpile. I'll be good to go, right? This is great. I love the idea of this. I absolutely love the idea of doing this and stockpiling this for 92 cents a box. Now, I know prices will vary. You might go on Amazon today and maybe it's not that price, but when I got it last week, that's what it was. So, and not only that, but I have Amazon Prime, so it's free shipping. And I ordered it like 10 o'clock at night. I love doing that. And then they say next day arrival. I'm a sucker for that. Yes. So next day arrival comes. I'm going to put a picture up here for you. And it came in this box, which was solid, a good solid box. But the top of it was almost like framed out like a picture frame. And you could see in the middle of it, the boxes of macaroni and cheese. Okay, kind of an unusual box. And, but anyway, that's how it came. Okay, no problem. But then I looked and you could see by the picture, and I'll show you here as well, there's one box that was literally ripped open. The noodles are exposed and so is the cheese packet. Look at that. There you go. That's how one of the boxes came. So I have 34 boxes that look like this and one box that looks like this. Now, I had two choices, and this is one of the things I want to talk to you about. Making wise choices. When you spend your money, how you spend your money, where you spend your money, how you use your money. I want to use my money wisely. So do price comparisons. I checked out four. I know at work, I can never purchase anything at work without having three price comparisons submitted with my purchase order. So if I do a PO and I want to buy a desk chair for my desk, I have to do three different price comparisons, submit that with my PO before I'm allowed to purchase that item. That's a smart shopper. We should take that same idea of business and, you know, look at things that we're buying. Now, some of you might only have one grocery store in your town, and that's the only one you can get to. And you can't do, you know, comparisons with other stores. No problem. You then can compare the prices of maybe a brand name versus store brand, maybe another brand name, and do a comparison of that in your local grocery store. You can still do price comparisons maybe differently in your store. But doing a price comparison, here I go and I get 92 cents a box versus the highest being $1.52. So great deal, right? Okay, so that was my first option. How do I want to spend my money? How do I want to use my money? How do I want to save my money? And all the rest. So I went and I did my price comparison to find I can not only get enough for my pantry and my stockpile, but I can have it delivered to my home. I don't have to go out and get it. And I can save, you know, somewhere on 50 cents a box times 35. We could have saved, you know, 50 cents a box, 35 boxes. That's money in my wallet that I could put toward something else. But now I have a choice to make. I got this ripped open, right? I can't use this in good faith and serve my family food that, you know, was it exposed to elements on the UPS bus, you know, truck, whatever. So here's a choice. Some of you might say, don't worry about it. It was 92 cents. It's one box. Take that box, pitch it. You've got 34 more boxes. You're in good shape. Don't worry about it. It's not a big deal. The rest of the boxes are fine. And the rest of the boxes were, they were encased in this box. They were all fine. This to me looked like maybe somebody grabbed the box to lift it, probably stuck their hand in it and ripped part of the top of the cardboard box. And that's my guess. I don't know. Or it was damaged. Why didn't the driver say something when it was delivered back to Amazon to say, hey, this box was delivered and Amazon contact me to say, what would you like to do? So my first choice would have been just to pitch it. My second choice was to contact Amazon, which I did. More so that I was annoyed that it was allowed to be delivered like that. I don't agree with that. So I asked them, I didn't open it. You know, I kept the box intact. I took pictures. I sent them a complaint. They asked for pictures. I sent them the pictures. And they said, what would you like to do? Would you like the item replaced or refunded? And I said, I would like the item refunded and I would like a free shipping label to ship back the other product. I don't feel I should have to pay for shipping when you allowed me to get a damaged product. Hands down, round of applause for Amazon. They said, keep the initial box of 34 good ones, just one broken one, and we will replace it for free. They refunded my initial box of macaroni and cheese 100%. Then they sent a replacement for free. So I now have 69 good boxes plus one, 70 boxes, if you will, of macaroni and cheese for free. Now, I insisted, you know, I'll send it back. I didn't feel that, you know, I had any right to keep the initial set of macaroni and cheese. I'll send it back. They insisted, no, this is the way the deal went down. I now have 69 boxes of macaroni and cheese for the pantry and stockpile. This is now the end of April. It will last me all the way through the summer and into early fall. We're stocked up on macaroni and cheese. I made a wise choice. I wanted to spend my money, number one, the best price I could get for the product. Number two, came with free shipping. It eased the, you know, in the comfort of my own home. I didn't have to go out and shop and all the rest. That was an added bonus. But then being a smart shopper, when a product is damaged or there's something wrong, not like what I did in not checking the battery, not investigating more, not going on YouTube or Google or reading a book or something on how else can I make this work. You know what? It was a blessing. The Lord just provided somebody smart at the other end, at the other dealer, to say the battery is upside down. The same thing with this. Using your brain to say, hey, damaged product. I should not have to be paying for damaged product. I need to contact them and find out what is the best solution we could agree upon. And that's what happened on my macaroni and cheese. So for 92 cents a box, I am now 69 boxes of macaroni and cheese invested into this for my pantry and stockpile. And I've got so many other great things to share with you and tips coming up. We're going to be talking on the next video on ways to earn money, maybe not even leaving your own home. So that's an option for you. How do I sell online? Who do I use? How easy is it? What are the pros and cons? Plus, a little extra bonus part of the video will be the three Wilsons, Graham, Gavin, and Lynn, discussing on how we have earned money, extra money, and maybe some ideas and tips for you. Yes, you might have to leave your home for some of this, but if you're looking to supplement your income and you can't do a part-time job, like I can't do part-time work because I work full-time and then I have two men at home, both on disability, that I need to cook for, clean for, attend to, take care of, and all the rest. And so for me to get a part-time job outside of the home would be difficult, but there are ways to earn money on the side, and we'll talk about that on our next video.